The jewel in Brighton's seaside crown was once the West Pier. It had been the finest Victorian pier in Britain, but throughout the 20th century, it had fallen into disrepair. And then, in 2003, it was all but destroyed by an arson attack. Brighton Council were on the hunt for a must-see attraction that reflected the original pioneering spirit of the West Pier, but with a 21st century twist. Meanwhile, 60 miles away, the architectural wizards behind the iconic London Eye, Julia Barfield and David Mark, had come up with a new and exciting visitor attraction that they thought would be the solution.
The success of the London Eye was such that we got approached by many people wanting to replicate it. And so we kind of looked at what was the essence of the London Eye, and we then looked at how we could replicate that experience in a different form.
David and Julia's design for the i360 would see visitors rise up into the sky to get a panoramic peek at the breathtaking surroundings. It was decided the perfect spot for it would be in the shadow of the remains of the old West Pier.
It is the site of the original West Pier, which is one of the only Grade 1 listed piers in the country. It was one of the most innovative piers in its time, and sadly, it burnt down. So it was like the phoenix from the flames, really.
The final design for the i360 would be a world first, as well as the tallest structure in all of Sussex. The 531-foot tower is made up of 17 stacked steel cans that get taller and thinner as they go up. They're held together by 1,336 bolts, weighing a combined 30 tons. The 900-ton tower supports a 59-foot-wide toughened glass and steel pod that's 10 times the size of a London Eye capsule and can hold up to 200 people. It uses state-of-the-art cable car technology to drive the pod up and down at less than 1 mile per hour.